Hello, and welcome to my poetry reading, Beachhead. Bonjour, et bienvenue à ma lecture de poésie, Tête de pont. I am grateful for the opportunity to be part of the National Program Readings in Canada and the financial assistance provided by the Canada Council of the Arts through the Writers Union of Canada. I would like to acknowledge the fact that this poetry reading takes place in the traditional territory of many nations, including the Mississaugas of the Credit, the Anishinaabeg, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat peoples, and is now home to many diverse First Nations, Inuit, and Métis peoples. We also acknowledge that Toronto is covered by Treaty 13 with the Mississaugas of the Credit. I'd like to start off the poetry reading with a poem that talks a bit about my childhood and who I am. The poem is called The Mandelbrot Set. The Mandelbrot Set is simply the equation that describes the fractals and was called the thumbprint of God. The Mandelbrot Set. I dreamt I was at my grandparents' house once more in the Danube Plain. An invisible hand knocked on the kitchen window. The kitchen was crowded with cousins and neighbors. A stove was at the forefront of the action with boiling pans and painted wooden spoons. An orange cat was always on the prowl. On a corner of the dining table, tarragon sprigs were laid out to dry. The hand knocked again. Zn plus 1 equals Zn squared plus C. The hand wrote on the window pane. The Mandelbrot set, you know, letters and numbers that make up the fractal formula. Z is closer to lemon rind, N is evasive, C is industrious, 1 is curious and smart, 2 is oh so elegant. White curtains fluttered briefly. Someone closed the door, they said. It's getting drafty in here. This is when I awoke, inside the fractal, in another time. I'd like now to read the poem Hiatus in English and French. I have a special bond with this poem. This is my very first poem published in North America. What is a hiatus? A hiatus is a chasm, a rupture within reality, where we find ourselves on two opposing ends, with somewhat of a void in between.
Hiatus. The pendulum moves from one bank of desire to the next outpost, which is the longing for your wisdom. A capsule of heather and bramble, a fluted movement of seeds and pollen, carried by northern winds on parachutes of wasp wings, and wind chimes over iris flowers. The space between the termini of feelings reeks of old herbariums, and amber insect sprites forced in the uncomfortable balance of opposing powers. I bear witness to the hiatus the pendulum inflicts with its incessant swings on the continuum of this unknown golden hour.
de parachute d'ailes de guêpe. L'espace près du terminus des sentiments, au parfum d'un vieil herbier, tient un tenail de farfadets d'ambre pris au va-et-vient de l'air. Je me porte témoin du hiatus que le bras de pendule inflige en son balancement dans le continuum des heures inconnues, ce conte d'insectes et d'or moulu.
I'd like now to introduce the keyword of this poetry reading, which is Beachhead, the hashtag, if you'd like. I've often wondered in the past when faced with daunting obstacles, how do I get from A to B when I don't have the means, the time, nor the inclination to do so? Yet it has to be done. That's when the concept of beachhead came into play. If only there would be an opening, I could slowly build upon it. Easier said than done. Life challenges are there for a reason, to teach us about our limits, our mortality, and our failures as human beings. Yet, in situations where we cannot pick our battles and which may be forced upon us, we can take refuge on that imaginary water's edge and dig our heels in. For me, navigating towards forbidden shores meant closing my eyes and allowing myself to daydream for a second or two. So I'd like to ask you this question. How do you get from A to B when it is hard to do so? So with that beachhead introduction out of the way, I will read the poem Beachhead, which was inspired by one of my good friend Tatiana Burgen, Arsenie, paintings. Beachhead. The moon behind your shadow, a windmill of clouds, fragmented. It feels as if I have come ashore after a long absence, trekking through green algae and inverted flower capsules. You are here. I have reached the beachhead of your presence. Getting from A to B sometimes involves the ability to read into the future. Here is my interpretation of reading through the future via fortune cookies. The poem November, which is the month of this reading. November. I remember your timbre in November. Glissando of unstressed vowels, rusted leaves that hide your passion, our mutterings in the rain, like short-lived messages inside a fortune cookie, read furtively under the table. Which make no sense, but frighten and delight us all at once, just like the sudden onset of the fall.
Novembre. Je me rappelle ton nom au mois de novembre, glissando des voyelles sans ancrage, des feuilles rousses qui abritent tes passions, nos chuchotements dans la pluie comme des messages courts à l'intérieur des biscuits chinois, lus en cachette sous la table.
et qui n'ont pas de sens, mais qui font comme l'automne, peur et plaisir à la fois.
But maybe, just maybe, navigating from A to B is just a matter of perspective. In the next section of my reading, I will talk about perspective using a reference to a French chateau as a pretext. At the chateau of Vaux-le-Vicomte, built in the middle of the 17th century in France, the landscape architect André Le Nôtre applied a hidden distortion called anamorphis abscondita to establish a forced, decelerated perspective. Here are a few extracts of my poem Vaux-le-Vicomte in English and French. Terrace. 1. It was the end of our affair in the middle of the summer, made of sand sketches and of the sea thudding at the end of the pier, our bodies embalmed by the fickle daylight, scent of acacia blooms, marooned inside inseams and wallets. That was the contents of the first Russian doll of my memory, an opening towards a low-key season. 2. There was always a terrace of sentiments, endless sparks suspended in the autumn air, play on a symmetry without axis. The optical illusion of a vantage point that negates reality, similar to the one Le Nôtre employed at Vaux-le-Vicomte, anamorphis abscondita. 3. Yellow post-it note, the curiosity, the lack of coherence, the arrogance that follows a coup de foudre, symptoms of the first hours. 4. An indication of who we are. Chinese lanterns of our quarrels, orange and white, flaring up under a gloomy sky. Still, our existence is measured by the cadence of the clouds.
Terrasse. C'était la fin de notre amour, au milieu d'un été fait d'esquisses de sable et de la huée de la mer au bout de la digue, nos corps embaumés par la lumière inconstante de l'aube, le parfum des acacias égaré dans nos poches. C'était là le contenu de la première poupée russe de ma mémoire. Une ouverture vers le remous d'une saison à voix basse. Feuille de lecture, post-it jaune. L'incohérence, la curiosité, la fatuité qui suit au coup de foudre, les symptômes des premières heures. Chaque passion s'explique par une dose d'exotisme, l'extrême avidité de déchiffrer un éloignement, un décalage de nous-mêmes, un indice de qui on est, les lanternes chinoises de nos paroles s'envolent sous un ciel maussade, bien que notre existence soit mesurée aux cadences des nuages.